ZSS versus Falco. No Pokemon trainer today.
Really?
At least in the past two sets we've seen on stream.
Well, how come no Pokemon trainer from Bankai? I thought he was solo main.
Well, so here's the thing. Against Palu, at least he didn't specify why. But in my eyes, it was mostly to... It was mostly to just keep up your mobility. You want to be fast against a character like Palu, because she herself is incredibly mobile. ZSS outrun... She's around the same run speed as Palu, but she does outspeed Palu in the air. She has insanely good air mobility. Palu does not.
So he was going for the more mobile pick as opposed
exactly.
to like the, I suppose, offensively flexible.
Pokemon Trainer is one of those characters that... Very solid, very good character, not very mobile.
Yes.
Both Squirtle and Ivysaur are on the slower side. Squirtle's somewhere like in the middle, somewhere towards the faster side. He's like a Mario of sorts, kind of in the middle.
Yeah, because the thing is that movement is very important in this game at a fundamental level. If you understand and have responses to every one of your opponent's tools, movement will often be the make or break. So I can see why that'd be really important from Bankai. And his ZSS is doing pretty all right, but a stock down now and slowly gaining percentage. It's kind of looking like he's having a bit of trouble.
Oh, this should be a stock on Falco. No, Falco's heavy enough.
Falco's heavy enough, although he does still have to get back. Good job tossing up the up air.
Actually surprised he didn't get hit by that there. I thought the last bit of that laser. But clearly not accurate to the visualization there, is that move. Nice.
Up B out of shield and falls out. I know that has been a common trend from what I understand.
And
ZSS is up B to fall.
Tilde's been doing a really good job of recognizing the defensive options of Bankai and clicking long lingering hitboxes to deal with them. He's been clicking up tilt on his spot dodges, fair on his spot dodges.
Yep.
That's going to be untackable as heck.
Yep.
That was untackable like 20% ago.
Yes. Very high percent, very high speed, difficult to tech at that point. Puts out the jab and wins it, but doesn't actually get the completion on that one because he didn't have enough faith in it. That's fine. But you will see,
there.
Like, when he goes off stage here, he puts the lasers up. He's trying to put those out to I guess, preemptively put a hitbox out for, I don't know, I forget what it's called. It's not bouncing fist, but whatever her kick is, the dive kick.
Yeah. I think it's just dive kick, actually. Like, just dive kick.
Yes.
I want to say. But yeah, so. When it comes to Falco in this matchup, one of the things that ZSS does have going for her is that you can't really get edgeguarded as this character. This character is like near unedgeguardable in this game, and as she was in 4.
Yes. It's possible, but it's definitely you have to call out where she's going to be. It's not so much that you can cover all of her options, you just have to hope that you get the correct one.
The last hit didn't hit him, so that actually may have very well killed at 170.
Yes. All right.
Back around block.
Barrett doesn't actually go for a punish off of that one. I would think ZSS has a decent enough out of shield to get back here.
Yeah, and I'm saying, so Falco is a character that benefits a lot from edge guarding. So that not really being a factor is kind of a big deal. However, ZSS is a character that is very good.
Out of shield, down air.
Just do literally anything else, my guy.
Yes.
Excuse me?
Interesting.
Anyway. ZSS, on the other hand, has really good edge guarding, and Falco is an edge guardable character. But that's going to be enough from there. Gonna be able to take out Bankai stock.
Yep. A little aggressive on the tech chase, yeah, but he got the neutral tech, and I guess he just mistimed it.
That's enough. Out of blocks. That's frame 4 out of block. So.
That's pretty good.
Actually, no. The move itself is frame 4. I think it's frame 5 because extra frame jump squat, things like that.
Gotcha.
So I think about frame 5.
Still, frame 5 is nothing to sneeze at.
No, not at all. Most characters do not have a frame 5 option at block.
No. All right. Well, there, not playing it too crazy, although he does go All right.
There, ZSS fair. Looking for an edge guard. He jumped. That's a risky jump there.
Yes.
Gets back. Sybee's enough.
Because he could have easily gotten whacked right back up, especially with ZSS. ZSS has some decent distance, I think.
Yes. Oh, up to bear
is a
confirm, and that's a dev.
That's the B&B.
Yeah. That's crazy. Falco is so much better in this game. Thank God.
So now, I have no idea about the percentage ranges
it's,
of up tilt.
I feel like it's relatively small, but like, who cares?
Is it?
It's up tilt bare. I think it's like one. It's probably around like a 15 to 10, like 20%.
Because I feel like I see it at lower percents too, but I'm probably
No. I'm saying as a kill.
Oh, as
a kill. In terms of how like often it works, is for like 70 to like 120, but. I think in terms of killing, only kills around like 110 to 120.
See, now this is what I would have put money on for Bankai doing from the beginning, because even, I mean, Falco's got good combos and all that, and he's got decent offstage presence. He's actually got some pretty good aerials, but this dominates the stage a lot more. And Falco, as good as he is in the air, he doesn't have the best neutral on stage.
He's never really had the best ground buttons. He's never really had... I mean, well, actually, I take that back, because he has up tilt in this game.
Yes,
but
good.
But outside of anti-airs, he doesn't have super solid ground buttons. His jab is a lot worse in this game than it was in 4. And Bungai is showing how a character that can control the stage like Squirtle, and as we're going to see now, Ivysaur, kind of can make it difficult for Falco. But once these characters get in disadvantage, oh boy, Falco has a lot of fun. Because Falco, one of the best advantage states in the game, period.
Ooh, he can still make it back.
He's back, okay, yeah. So the thing is, when you
that was supposed to be a tech chase, but he did it too low. He'll pay for it with his life.
Falco. So the thing is with Trainer that I was mentioning earlier, Falco has a really good advantage state. So Trainer, all of them have garbage disadvantage.
Yes.
Like Ivysaur, Squirtle, and Charizard do not hit the floor very easily. You have some mix, obviously, with your downbeat.
Is
it DI mix up? But come on, you can react to the up throw, my guy.
Yes. Still, I understand. Kind of scary to be in that position. You can see that he was waiting out. I'm almost sure he was waiting out the up smash.
Yeah. Nice. How are you smashing? I can't think about it.
Yeah, let's go for a reset on that one. Definitely avoids the grab there. That is something that a lot of Squirtles like to go for, especially at this kind of percent. Re-grab combos and setup.
Nice.
Snipes
it
with
not
the edge of the
yet.
Up tilt. That's pretty good. All right. Gets him back up. This is definitely a higher percent where you just want to get off stage.
Nice. I love it. Razor Leaf Nair. Up B. Yes.
Why is
Devin's
so
popping
good?
Off. He's like, yes.
Why
yes,
is Upbeat so good on Ivysaur? Real talk. All right. Just makes it with the air dodge. That was a good call.
Ooh. Bankai had the tech on deck. He says, I'm definitely going to. Nice. That was slight drift. I would have liked to have seen. I would have liked to have seen Tilde commit more there. But I like the mix up for Bankai.
I can appreciate that he didn't want to go too far just in case. But it seems like there's a little bit of wavering confidence on both sides here, because you saw earlier on Tilde had done the classic.
Oh, you're dead! Oh,
no,
okay,
he's not
okay,
dead.
Right.
See, well, you're seeing things like that. Is that like
also,
Tilde?
You can murder Charizard for doing that.
Yes.
Why did you? Bankai got away with one there, and
Tilde did not have a dedicated punish on deck for that, which is fine.
Yeah.
But it is very reactable to see. And then you had stuff like Bankai eating a point blank side B from Tilde.
Yeah.
And no punish, just like a hop out of shield.
That's one of those things where it's just like Smash 4 muscle memory still. Still, like, people will deny that the game's been out 6 years. Oh, it's been out 6 months, Smash 4 muscle memory. And you still have Smash 4 muscle memory in some instances.
Yes.
However, Smash 4 muscle memory still tells you to murder Charizard for side being your block. So, you're Falco, you have a million buttons there that'll just murder him. So, like, you have back air, you have up smash, you'll have...
Now, I feel like...
Oh!
See, another thing, right, is that I feel like we're... It's very conditioned on a lot of people now, like, oh, jumping out of shield is the answer. Because shield
drop
is very...
Yes, that's true. That's actually very...
So people who see, like, oh, this is a punish opportunity, jump out of shield even if there's no plan.
Yeah,
out of the jump
right.
out of shield. So we're going to see the switch over to Fox. More aggressive here. I think this could play out a little bit better, but that's provided he doesn't get caught in the mix.
Oh, that angle was... Nice.
That was a really good angle.
Nice.
He was basically
just
dead.
Just passed the down air, right.
Yes. Any other angle would have killed him.
Yeah.
Does catch the roll. Razor Leaf is really good.
Local Fox and Pokemon Trainer main Devin. Very happy with what's going on right now. Yeah, it's literally Devin's main.
So he actually had a punish there on the point blank Razor Leaf, but doesn't go for anything. It all seems like these two are like...
Nice.
They're working out the matchup as they go, but there could be more experience.
Now this is terrifying because...
That,
but I was more so referring to for Charizard because he goes into... Don't let this man mash.
You gotta wait it out, man.
Yeah, man. Don't let this man mash.
He's
reacting to his block getting hit, not the move that's hitting his block.
Yes, exactly.
Nah, these angles and these extensions above ledge have been really fantastic.
Yes.
I've actually liked it a lot from Kid until today.
And that's the thing, right, is that you normally don't see too many crazy angles because they're not particularly necessary, but these have been, like, very necessary, very good angles.
Yes. I'm enjoying the recovery coming out from Kid, for sure.
Yes.
You can't. So as Fox, you're very tempted to go for that full hop and that short hop.
Okay,
Nair.
Okay, see. So, no, you're talking about good recovery. He made a good recovery right there. Okay, running up smash. That's a Fox classic.
I like it.
All right. So that was a really, really poorly spaced fair, but that's okay.
Yeah.
Doesn't get punished for it too much. Goes for the up smash.
Oh, I like
why
the
not?
Read. Beautiful.
Changing through his Pokemon teams right now like they're getting burned by the Elite Four. Jesus Christ, calm down. All right.
Yes, yeah, some keep switching.
Playing for
get me out of here.
I understand, though. He wants Squirtle for those early combos.
Yeah, that's one of those things that you can see the infamiliarity with him as a Fox player. And still, they obviously, in this game, known for Falco.
Yes.
He up tilted it when he went for fair, yet the up tilt hadn't yet sent it to tumble yet. So he didn't really know his percent super well. So, yeah, just something.
All right, Nair Shore.
Oh, you can't land.
Fair, yes.
You can't land.
Very difficult to land against Ivysaur if you don't have some really good.
Ivy, actually, the hitbox clanked with the.
That could have been death.
Yeah, that could have been really scary.
That was
if there was a back air with an air, or an air there.
Yes.
Asash, just stay in the air.
Yep. A lot of. See, you'll see Tildy doing a little bit of the waiting right, but then there's not the greatest punishment that there could be, but still doing a good job. They're putting the pressure on this time after he gets hit with the close-up Razor Leaf, but that will do it. Razor Leaf, so the farther away you are from Razor Leaf, the less advantageous Ivysaur is, but
yes.
If you're too far away, then Ivysaur can start running up with it. So what you want to do is that early percents, you want to stay clear of close-up, you want to be about mid-range, and then the higher percents you are, you want to be a little bit closer, but not so close that he can get kill confirmed.
Exactly.
It's a lot to jump.
It's one of those things. Nice, anti-air Tilde.
I'm surprised that beat out the Nair.
That's a good response. Keep in mind, Fox's feet and head are intangible.
That's
so,
true.
Yeah.
They are, we're going by the lore, his legs are still metal.
His legs are indeed made of metal.
That is scary.
He just landed straight to him charging a smash attack. I admire the gusto. But.
Yes. So now you'll see right there is that Bankai did a retreating Nair.
Are you dead?
Close to it. So Bankai had done a retreating Nair on there and didn't let the full thing hit his shield, which actually could have opened him up for a punish, but he was staying back, counting on the fact that Tildy would not punish it to give himself some more space and return to neutral.
Bankai's definitely going to mash. He's going to mash.
He's had a good success
he's
rate.
He's going to mash.
He's had a very good success rate.
Bankai?
He's
going to mash. Look at this. He's like, I'm going
to
stay.
The only way to counter a mash is with another mash. Can we see the up smash from Fox?
He's gonna up throw him. He's gonna up throw him. That hit! That hit!
Are you kidding me? He put out like a sliding forward tilt. Can we see that again, Devin? Real quick.
Are you kidding me?
He put out his tail. I saw it for like 2 frames. Hold up. No, he turned around!
Charizard just stuck his neck out!
Yeah, he's like, oh man, is this the executioner's block?
Oh my god!
Can I get sent back to the Pokemon Center, please?